without a husband and needing a job and everything else and just her wild lifestyle. So she dropped him off with Ira's parents, who raised Willie and his sister Bobby for the rest of their lives. Although their parents kept coming back into their lives all the time. Every year they'd see their parents a couple times. They'd just sort of drop into town and say hi and then move on. So it's kind of an easy way of having a family or an extended family. Grandfather bought Willie a guitar when he was 6 years old. Willie had sang gospel songs in church, and he wrote his first song when he was seven. His first band at age nine was a band called Bohemian Polka, which played Bohemian polka music. He picked cotton. He played football, basketball, and baseball in high school. He got in fights and in trouble with boys and girls. He started playing honky tonks when he was 13. He loved the music of Jimmy Rogers and Hank Williams and Bob Wills and Lefty Frizzell and Django Reinhardt, Frank Sinatra, Louis Armstrong. So a man of his time. At the end of high school, with the Korean War sort of breathing down his neck, he signed up for the Air Force. He was there for 9 months, which seems like a long time for Willie Nelson. He got a medical discharge based on a back injury he'd gotten from farm work, a real back injury, not bone spurs or anything. For the next few years, he got married a couple times. He played in bands in several towns and cities, worked as a radio disc jockey in every place that a band got a job, all for no wages, basically. And he wrote songs that nobody really wanted to buy. He finally made it to Nashville, where people bought his songs and then recorded him after about, I don't know, 10 years or so. And he initially worked with Chet Atkins, who was the
Yeah,
sort of the
sure.
master of the Nashville sound with all sorts of great strings and Chet Atkins's amazing guitar and background singers. But there were too many strings and background voices for Willie. So he moved to Austin in 72 and became associated with a kind of music called outlaw country. He had a group called the Highwaymen with Johnny Cash and Waylon Jennings and Chris Christopherson, and they didn't have any of that string shit. It was all just guitars and attitude. He was married four times. He's has eight children, and he seems to be on good terms with all of them, kids and wives alike. The extended family vibe probably comes from his childhood, quite naturally, and the family vibe on stage, because members of his family perform in his band and tour with him, is also in the audience, which is kind of like the Grateful Dead deadheads. There are people at any Woody, Willie Nelson concert that have been to hundreds of them and have seen him in every city in the United States. So it's kind of his vibe. He's written over 350 songs. He's recorded over 100 albums. He's been in over 30 movies, starting with The Electric Horseman, which was based on his life. He's written several books. He's been an activist for biodiesel, made of vegetable fuel, and legalized pot. He's the co-chair of the advisory board of Normal for normalizing, for legalizing pot. At one point, he owed the IRS $32 million in 1990. He cleared his debts by selling all his assets, his horses, his farms, everything he had, and releasing a record, a double album called The IRS Tapes, Who'll Buy My Memories? And the sales from that record and the sale of all his assets paid off his debt. He then got a lawyer who made sure he paid his IRS after that. So that's enough background for right now. If I do another one, I'll add some other stories of him. Then I'll tell you something. But here's a song called One Day at a Time, written in 1965. And it's from his first album with Chet Atkins. And at the time, the song was part of his evolving personal philosophy. Thanks to Alcoholics Anonymous, the sentiment is always relevant. I believe one.
Is your sound on, Larry?
I'll do it right now.
Very good.
There we go. I live one day at a time. I dream one dream at a time. Yesterday's dead, and tomorrow is blind. I live one day at a time. I guess that you're surprised. I guess that you're surprised to see me back at home. don't you know, but you know how much I miss you when I'm gone. Please don't ask how long I plan to stay. It never crossed my mind. I live one day at a time. See that sparrow fly across the crowded cloudy sky, searching for a patch of sunlight, so am I. I wish I didn't have to follow, and perhaps I won't in time. I live one day at a time. I live one day at a time. I dream one dream at a time. Yesterday's dead and tomorrow is blind, and I live one day at a time. I live one day at a time. I dream one dream at a time. Yesterday's dead and tomorrow is blind, and I live one day at a time. And I live one day at a time. Thank you.
Lovely. To a good start.
Good.
For that matter, I love that, Larry.
Yeah, I do too. I've always liked that song. Here's one that I'm sure you'll recognize. It's called Always on My Mind. It was originally recorded by Brenda Lee in 1972. And then a guy named Elvis Presley made a recording of it that became one of his signature songs. People thought the song had been written for Elvis, especially because he was having marital troubles at the time. But the writer had written it before he had any idea Elvis would be doing it, and he really just wrote it from his own experience. But it's also one of those songs that's kind of a classic guy's lie about, I was still thinking of you even though I was cheating on you with five other women, that kind of thing. Anyway, well, I don't want to spoil it. It's a beautiful song. Maybe I didn't love you quite as often as I could have. Maybe I didn't treat you quite as good as I should have. If I made you feel second best, girl, I'm sorry I was blind. But you were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. Maybe I didn't hold you all those lonely, lonely times. I guess I never told you I'm so happy that you're mine. Little things I should have said and done, I just never took the time. But you were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. Tell me that your sweet love hasn't died. Give me one more chance to keep you satisfied. I'll keep you satisfied. Little things I should have said and done, I just never took the time. But you were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. You were always on my mind. On my mind.
Well, that was great, Larry.
Thanks. All right, what do we got here? Here's a song called Pretty Paper. It was written in 1963, and Roy Orbison had the first recording with it. Can imagine how privileged Willie felt to have Roy Orbison singing a song of his. Roy Orbison went into the studio to record it. He had a 102 degree fever. Did it anyway, came out great. Willie did his version in 1964, 2 years later. And it's a Christmas classic. Pretty paper. Pretty ribbons of blue. Wrap your presents to your darling from you. Pretty pencils to write, I love you. Pretty paper, pretty ribbons of blue. Crowded streets. Busy feet hustle by you. Downtown shoppers, Christmas is nigh. There he sits all alone on the sidewalk, hoping that you won't pass him by. Should you stop? Better not, much too busy. You're in a hurry, my, how time does fly. In the distance, the ringing of laughter. And in the midst of the laughter, he cries. Pretty paper. Pretty ribbons of blue. Wrap your presents to your darling from you. Pretty pencils to write, I love you. Pretty paper, pretty ribbons of blue. This song was inspired by a guy named Frankie Brierton, a man in Fort Worth whose legs were atrophied below the knee from spinal meningitis. He moved with rollers selling paper and pencils in front of Leonard's department store. And Willie had seen this guy and wrote the song based on that. So I just thought I'd do the verse again because it's knowing the story is helpful. Crowded streets, busy feet, hustle by you. Downtown shoppers, Christmas is nigh. There he sits all alone on the sidewalk, hoping that you won't pass him by. Should you stop? Better not. Much too busy. You're in a hurry. My, how time does fly. And in the distance, the ringing of laughter. And in the midst of the laughter, he cries, pretty paper, pretty ribbons of blue. Wrap your presents to your darling from you. Pretty pencils to write, I love you. Pretty paper, pretty ribbons of blue.
Sad story.
Very beautiful, Larry.
Yeah, it is a sad story, no doubt about it.
Thanks for telling us the story.
What?
Thanks for telling us the story. I was trying to imagine.
Yeah, yeah. Here's one called Funny How Time Slips Away. One of the first songs he ever wrote. It's from 1961. I mean, one of the songs he ever wrote and made a hit with and stuff. Willie recorded it in 62. There are great recordings of this all over the place. Joe Hinton had the first hit, Wanda Jackson, Brenda Lee, Elvis Presley, Al Green, The Spinners, Lyle Lovett, George Jones. And Glenn Campbell recorded it on his very last album. Great version of it as well. Well, hello there. It's been a long, long time. How you doing? I guess I'm doing fine. It's been so long now. And it seems like it was only yesterday. Ain't it funny how time just slips away? How's your new love? I hope he's doing fine. I heard you told him you love him till the end of time. Well, now that's the same thing that you told me. It seems like only yesterday. Ain't it funny how time slips away? I'm gonna go now. I guess I'll see you around. But I don't know when, though. Don't know when I'll be back in town. But remember what I told you, that in time you're gonna pay. It's surprising how time just slips away.
Yeah, you have an image, okay?
What did you push?
I just pushed something. I don't know what it was.
Oh, I did want to show you something.
Here's another early song. This was the first song that Willie recorded, I believe. And there's an interesting story to this. It's from 1957. And he wrote this song, but the credits for the song go to Claude Gray, who recorded a version of it, Paul Buskirk, and Walter Breland. And the song is inspired by Willie's grandmother, who raised him. And Willie sold it to Buskirk and these partners. It was written when he was a DJ in Portland, Oregon. And he played it for May Boren Axton, who became a sort of a friend-type manager for him for quite a while. It was also Hoyt Axton's mother, who recommended that Willie move to Nashville because this song is great and he could sell, he could sell his songs in Nashville. But it was too expensive for Willie to live in Nashville at the time. He was very poor, so he moved to Houston. And in Houston, he went out to dinner with this promoter, producer named Buskirk, Paul Buskirk. And at the end of the meal, he didn't have money for the check. So he sold him Family Bible, the song, for $50, and Buskirk would pay the bill. So he did that. Buskirk went and recorded this guy, Claude Gray, singing it, and sold Claude Gray a share in the song for $100. Gray's song version went to number 7 on the country charts. And when it did, Willie used the money he got to move to Nashville and start selling songs and started making money immediately. Anyway, this is it. There's a Family Bible on the table. Its pages worn and hard to read. But the Family Bible on the table will ever be my key to memories. At the end of the day when work was over and when the evening meal was done, Dad would read to us from the Family Bible and we'd count our blessings one by one. I can see us sitting round the table when from the Family Bible Dad would read, and I can hear my mother softly singing, Rock of Ages, Rock of Ages, cleft for me. This world of ours is full of trouble, but this old world would also better be if we find more Bibles on the table and mother singing Rock of Ages, cleft for me. I can't see us sitting round the table when from the Family Bible Dad would read, and I can hear my mother softly singing, Rock of Ages, Rock of Ages, cleft for me. Rock of Ages, Rock of Ages, cleft for me.
Nice.
Yeah, it's a nice song.
One person who did a wonderful version of that was Merle Haggard.
Yes, he did.
But I had no idea that Willie wrote it.
He did indeed.
Wow. Glad to know that.
Let's see if I can get a little more. Wait, what's going on here? Sorry. I don't know what I did wrong. Thank you. good. I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so lonely. I'm crazy, crazy for feeling so blue. I knew that you'd love me as long as you wanted. And then someday you'd leave me for somebody new. Worry, why do I let myself worry? Wondering, what in the world did I do? I'm crazy for thinking that my love could hold you. I'm crazy for trying and crazy for crying, and I'm crazy for loving you. I'm crazy for thinking that my love could hold you. I'm crazy for trying, and I'm crazy for crying, and I'm crazy for loving you.
One of the greats.
It is one of the greats. You know, Willie wrote all these, you know, songs at around the same time. Nightlife, which I'll do maybe some other time. Funny How Time Slips Away, Crazy, all in the same week. This one he sold to Patsy Cline. He knew Hank Cochran, who had a connection with Patsy Cline, and had spoken to Patsy's husband. And Patsy had just recorded I Fall to Pieces. You know, Willie had written the song as if he were a man whose relationship had ended. It was originally called Stupid instead of Crazy. Patsy, anyway, had earlier heard Nightlife and she didn't like it. She didn't want any more songs about loss of love. But her husband thought Crazy would be just a natural for her. There are two stories about what happened next. One is that Hank Cochran drove the song to Patsy's house late at night, like 1 a.m, waited in the car while her husband took the tape and played it for her in bed. The other claim, Willie says he took the car to their house. Anyway, either way, she liked it, she recorded it, became a number one country song, entered the pop charts. 1996, it became the all-time most played song on American jukeboxes. And in 2024, Rolling Stone ranked it as number 3 in the greatest country songs of all time. So, anyway, this next song is one that'll never be in the Country Hall of Fame. It's one that Willie wrote in 2012. And he recorded it with Snoop Dogg and Jamie Johnson and Kris Kristofferson. Roll me up and smoke me when I die. And if anyone don't like it, look him in the eye. I didn't come here and I ain't leaving, so sit around and cry. Just to roll me up and smoke me when I die. You won't see no sad and teary eyes when I get my wings and it's due time to fly. Just call my friends and tell them there's a party, come on by. Just to roll me up and smoke me when I die. Roll me up and smoke me when I die. If anyone don't like it, just look them in the eye. I didn't come here and I ain't leaving, so to sit around and cry. Just roll me up and smoke me when I die. When I go out, I've been here long enough. So sing and dance and tell more jokes and stuff. Just keep that music playing, it'll be a good goodbye. Just roll me up and smoke me when I die. Just roll me up and smoke me when I die. If anyone don't like it, you can look them in the eye. I didn't come here and I ain't leaving, so don't sit around and cry. Just roll me up and smoke me when I die. Well, take me out and build a roaring fire. Just roll me in the flames for about an hour. Then pull me out and twist me up and point me toward the sky. And roll me up and smoke me when I die. Just roll me up and smoke me when I die. And if anyone don't like it, you can look him in the eye. I didn't come here, I ain't leaving. Dude, don't sit around and cry. And just smoke me up, roll me up and smoke me when I die. Anyway, really song was released on 420 in 2012, 420 being the national Get Stoned Day. As a teacher, teaching on 420 was always a kind of odd thing. You know, kids giving me, you know, all sorts of signs like, you know, don't bust me, I'm high. Yeah, anyway. That's that one. Here's one that's from an album called The Redheaded Stranger. Redheaded Stranger was a breakthrough album for Willie Nelson. It was a concept album. And kind of like it was the country Sergeant Pepper. And because there were all these songs that were related, there was a kind of narrative. And it started with this song called The Redheaded Stranger by Edith Lindemann Kalish and Carl Stutz, and it was recorded by Arthur Guitar Boogie Smith and John Loudermilk and Eddie Arnold. You know, so Willie knew this song from when he was a kid, and he used to sing it as a lullaby to his children. I don't like the way this sounds. Let me just see if I can do something about that. Oh, I can't do that. The redhead. The redheaded stranger from Blue Rock, Montana, rode into town one day, and under, having a hard time here. In the red-headed stranger from Blue Rock, Montana, rode into town one day, and under his knees, I don't know why I can't sing this well, red-headed stranger from Blue Rock, and under his, oh, there it. That's why I couldn't sing it. All right, I'll try it one. There we are. The red-headed stranger from Rock, Montana, rode into town one day, and under his knees was a raging black stallion, and walking behind was a bay. The red-headed stranger had eyes like thunder, and his lips, they were sad and tired. His little lost love was asleep on the hillside, and his heart was heavy as night. Don't cross him, don't boss him, he's wild in his sorrow, ride in and hide in his pain. Don't fight him, don't spite him, just wait till tomorrow. maybe you ride on again. The yellow-haired lady leaned out of her window, watched as he passed her way. She drew back in fear at the sight of the stallion, but cast greedy eyes on the bay. How could she know that the dancing bay pony meant more to him than life? This was the horse that his little lost darling had ridden when she was his wife. Don't cross him, don't boss him, he's wild in his sorrow, ride in and hide in his pain. Don't fight him, don't spite him, just wait till tomorrow, maybe he'll ride on again. Yellow-haired lady came down to the tavern and looked up the stranger there. He bought her a drink and gave her some money. He just didn't seem to care. She followed him out as he saddled the stallion, laughed as she grabbed at the bay. He shot her so quick, they had no time to warn her. She never heard anyone say, don't cross him, don't boss him, he's wild in his sorrow, ride in and hide in his pain. Don't fight him, don't spite him, just wait till tomorrow, maybe he'll ride on again. The yellow-haired lady was buried at sunset. The stranger went free, of course. You can't hang a man for killing a woman who's trying to steal your horse. This is the tale of the red-headed stranger, and if he should pass your way, stay out of the path of the raging black stallion, and don't lay a hand on the bay. Don't fight him, don't spite him, don't cross him, don't boss him, he's wild in his sorrow, ride in and hide in his pain. Don't fight him, don't spite him, just wait till tomorrow, maybe he'll ride on again.
You know, the record company almost never released that because they felt it sounded like demos, because he stripped his band down to three people, and it was his huge selling album. Sold
yeah.
Millions.
Yeah, it was really a giant album. The record company had no idea. He was never really understood by most of his record companies. They had made a movie of it, and Willie Nelson starred as the redheaded stranger.
That's right.
All right, let's stay in the cowboy mode a little bit here. What do we got here? If you had not have fallen, then I would not have found you. Angel flying too close to the ground. I patched up your broken wing and hung around for a while, trying to keep your spirits up and your fever down. I knew someday that you'd fly away. For love's the greatest healer to be found. So leave me if you need to, I will still remember. Angel, flying too close to the ground. So fly on past the speed of sound. I'd rather see you up than see you down. So leave me if you need to, I will still remember. Angel flying too close to the ground. So leave me if you want to, I will still remember. Angel flying too close to the ground.
Lovely.
All right. Here's a here's a cowboy song you may not have heard, or you may have, I don't really know. It's called Cowboys Are Frequently Secretly Fond of Each Other. And he received a tape from the bass player for Saturday Night Live back in the mid-80s, a bassist named Tony Garnier, who went on to become Bob Dylan's bass player for many, many tours, still is. And Willie said, I thought it was the funniest goddamn song I'd ever heard. I'd heard it on our bus for 20 years, and people would come in and play it. And when Brokeback Mountain came out, it seemed like just a good time to kick this song out of the closet. So he released it on Valentine's Day in 2006. And enough introduction, you'll get the idea. Well, there's many a strange impulse out on the plains of West Texas. There's many a young boy who feels things he can't comprehend. And a small town don't like it when somebody falls between sexes. No, a small town don't like it when a cowboy has feelings for men. I believe to my soul that inside every man there's the feminine. And inside every lady there's a deep manly voice loud and clear. Well, a cowboy may brag about things that he's done with his women. But the ones who brag loudest are the ones who are most likely queer. Cowboys are frequently secretly fond of each other. What did you think all them saddles and boots was about? There's many a cowboy who don't understand the way that he feels for his brother. And inside every cowboy there's a lady that'd love to slip out. And there's always somebody who says what the others just whisper. And mostly that someone's the first one to get shot down dead. So when you talk to a cowboy, don't treat him like he was a sister. You can't fuck with a lady that's sleeping in each cowboy's head. Cowboys are frequently secretly fond of each other. What did you think all them saddles and boots was about? There's many a cowboy who don't understand the way that he feels for his brother. And inside every lady, there's a cowboy who'd love to come out. And inside every cowboy, there's a lady who'd love to slip out. 10 men for each woman was the rule way back when on the prairie. And somehow those cowboys must have kept themselves warm late at night. Cowboys are famous for getting riled up about fairies. But I'll tell you the reason a big strong man gets so uptight. Cowboys are frequently secretly fond of each other. That's why they wear leather. That's why they wear leather and Levi's and belts buckled tight. There's many a cowboy who don't understand the way that he feels for his brother. And in there's many a cowboy who's more like a lady at night. Cowboys are frequently secretly fond of each other. Even though they take speed and drive pickups and shoot their big guns. There's many a cowboy who don't understand the way that he feels for his brother. And there's many a cowboy keeps quiet about things that he's done.
Amazing.
Strange little song.
I haven't heard that one.
That is very cute.
You know, I like Willie and his musicality so much that I even bought an album where he doesn't sing. And you
where
can
he just
hear
plays
the
guitar?
Whole, you can hear wow. the whole of the guitar. Yeah.
Well, he's a very good guitar player.
Yeah, you skipped 7 Spanish Angels. Did you?
I did, yeah. I don't have time for everything I got here. So.
Okay, what do you want to do now?
I think I will do The Border.
Okay.
This comes from his most recent album or his most recent album but one, something like that. I work on the border. See what I see. I work on the border, and it's working on me. I lie awake at night, knowing what I know. There's a price on my head, every border patrol, where the smugglers do business. That's where I make a stand. I know this old desert like the back of my hand. I see greed in the bushes. I see snakes in the dark. Some are friends of my brothers. Can't you hear them dogs bark? I come home to Maria. At the end of the day, in the shape of a shadow, holding demons at bay. It's just the border, they say. It was Mexican soldier out of a black Humvee with their guns on their shoulders and at my partner. As they drove away laughing, but the message was clear. We don't care about nothing but the money down here. I come home to Maria in a bulletproof vest, with the weight of the whole wide world bearing down on my chest. It's just the border I get. From the shacks and the shanties come the hungry and poor. Some to drown at the crosses, some to suffer no more. Guess you heard about Campos and Rami Yen, both of them friends of mine, both good men. They did one thing right, and look what they got. Federal prison, where they're both gonna rot. I come home to Maria, where else would I go? Cross the river to die by myself, down in old Mexico. It's just the border, you know.
It reminds me of the series we started watching, Larry, Cowboy Cartel.
Yeah, very much like it.
Larry, what sound do you have on?
What?
Do you have original sound on your computer?
I do.
Okay.
You can't hear the guitar?
No, every once in a while it buzzes. It's good.
It buzzes. That's happening here. That's okay. The problem with the guitar. I just changed instruments. Okay. This is called Living in the Promised Land. Give us your tired and weak, and we will make them strong. Bring us your foreign songs, and we will sing along. Leave us your broken dreams, we'll give them time to mend. There's still a lot of love living in the promised land. Living in the promised land. Our dreams are made of steel. The prayer of every man is to know how freedom feels. There is a winding road across the shifting sand, and room for everyone living in the promised land. They came from distant isles, nameless woman, faithless child, like a bad dream. Till there was no room at all, no place to run, no place to fall. Give us our daily bread, we have no shoes to wear, no place to call our home, only this cross to bear. We are the multitudes, lend us a helping hand. Is there no love anymore? living in the promised land, living in the promised land. Our dreams are made of steel. Made of steel. The prayer of every man is to know how freedom feels. There is a winding road across the shifting sand, and room for everyone living in the promised land. Living in the promised land. Yeah, time for one more. It's pretty much the end of the day, isn't it? Yeah, all right, I'll save it for some other time. Anyway. All right, one more, on the road again. Get us back on the road. This came from a movie that Willie made called Honeysuckle Rose. And they wanted him to write a song for it, and so he came up with it on the spur of the moment, wrote it on a barf bag, apparently, and it's been one of his biggest hits ever since. On the road again, just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Going places that I've never been. Seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again. Like a band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning our way. And our way is on the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. And all the life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again. The road again. On the bad band of gypsies, we go down the highway. We're the best of friends, insisting that the world keep turning our way. And our way is on the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends. And I can't wait to get on the road again. And I just can't wait to get on the road again. There we are.
Perfect ending.
Well, thanks very much for putting up with my mistakes and for liking the music.
I like ending with that kind of energy. I love that.
Yeah.
Great. Good. Really good.
Thank you, Larry.
Thanks, Larry.
Thanks, Larry.
Thanks for coming. It was my pleasure. Come on, y'all.